Hi, I'm Tony. Welcome to Sports Bike Shop's video about the Nolan N60-6 helmet. If this new for 2022 helmet isn't the best value sporty lid on the market, then I'd like to hear what people think offers more value for their money. It's the Nolan N60-6, and it's their entry-level full-face helmet with a pre-installed pinlock max vision insert, a drop-down sun visor that's got an anti-fog coating, and it meets the new ECE 2206 safety standard, and you get all of that for 150 quid if you're happy with plain black or white, or 180 quid if you want to inject a little bit more colour into your life. The 150 quid starting price tag for this helmet means it's the cheapest lid so far to meet the new safety standard, which has to be a credit to Nolan. So let's run through the essentials. As usual for Nolan, the shell is made from Lexan, which is a high-grade polycarbonate. One of the frequent criticisms you hear of plastic-shelled helmets is that they make them heavy, but no one can say that about this N60-6, as this size medium helmet weighs in on our scales at 1,446 grams, which to my mind is pretty damn light. We've weighed 88 different helmet models since we started this project, and only 19 of them have been lighter than this one. The ventilation's decent too. There's a chunky slider on the chin, which allows air to flow through the top of the chin bar and then into the eye port. On top, there are twin scoops that pull air into the helmet, which then flows between two sections of the EPS impact liner before it can work through channels towards the rear exhaust vents. I found airflow through the chin vent to be more noticeable than through the vents on top. There isn't a direct route for air to flow through to your head from these vents, so it seems to be more a case of cooling down the EPS liner. So I'm sure that's effective over time, but it's not a case of opening that vent and feeling the air rush in to hit your skin. The visor for this lid is a tried and trusted one. It's the same one that Nolan used on their old N87, and it's also in use on the new N88. It's really simple to change, and it lifts and lowers with this one central tab just here. From fully up, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stages before the visor hits the seal, which leaves a small gap around the bottom for some air to get through if you need it. If you give it an extra push, then it clicks in place more securely. I found the two smallest openings here to be very useful when riding at low speed in town, and the visor also stayed up if I needed it to, rather than just shutting in the wind flow. It's protected against mist by a pinlock insert, which is max vision, so the outer edges won't interfere much or even at all with your vision. There's no pinlock branding on the insert, so I can't say for certain what grade it is, but it is a proper pinlock, and I'd say it's a pinlock 70, the middle of their three grades. You also get two bonuses with this visor and pinlock combo. One, the pinlock's already fitted when you buy the lid. It's not hard to fit a pinlock, but if I had a choice between fitting it myself or not fitting it, then I would always choose not fitting it. Secondly, if you need to adjust the tension of the pinlock to get a better seal against the inner surface of the visor, then it's really easy on this lid. The adjusters on the outside here just rotate, and that alters the tension. Some helmet manufacturers who charge three times the price of this helmet for theirs would do well to look at this system and work out why theirs isn't easier. So the main visor for this helmet is backed up by an internal sun visor, which operates on this switch by the left-hand visor pivot. It's got a staged drop, so you can leave it partially down if you want as well. Another plus point for the Nolan, this has an anti-fog coating like pretty much every Nolan I've ever tried. If you're buying a helmet for commuting, then I think that's particularly important. In the mornings especially, there's often a lot of moisture in the air and often a low sun to contend with as well. So if the sun visor mists up, then you've got a choice of what's going to blind you today. Is it going to be the glare from the sun, or is it going to be the opaque bit of plastic that sat a couple of inches in front of your eyes? If you've got an anti-mist sun visor like this one, you don't have to have either of those problems. I used this for about a week's worth of daily commuting, so that's 300 miles or so, and that sun visor worked beautifully and stayed clear the whole time. Anyway, I'd best get off my soapbox, I suppose, and move on to the interior of the helmet. There's nothing flashy about this lining, but it works. It's fully removable, and actually it's really easy to change, as well as fitting in there nice and securely. And there's even a synthetic leather section around the base of the trim here to help make it more durable. So the cheek pads are what Nolan calls eyewear adaptive. If you wear specs and find there's not enough room to squeeze the spectacle arms in comfortably, then you pop the cheek pads out and pull out a small piece of foam at the top of each pad. And then once you've done that, hopefully there will be enough room for those spectacle arms. there are a couple of things that this helmet lacks over the next one up in Nolan's range, which is the N88 helmet. First of those is emergency release cheek pads. If this had them, that would make a medic's task a bit easier if you're unfortunate enough to have a spill and someone else needs to take your lid off for you. The second thing that's missing is probably something that will upset more people. There are no recesses for intercom speakers to slot into. I tried fitting a couple of intercoms anyway in the name of research. The first one I tried was a Cardo PackTalk Bold, and it was no good as there just wasn't enough room for both my ears and the speakers. The speakers that you get with Sennheiser's 20S Evo, the other one I tried, are slimmer, and I could stick those inside this lid and still wear it, but the speakers were right against my ear, and I'm not sure every rider would find that comfortable, especially when starting to ride longer distances. One final but important detail about the interior is the strap fastener. It does up with a micrometric buckle like all of Nolan's helmets, but this one's a basic pull and release, rather than the two-stage device that you get on more expensive Nolans. So let's cover sizing and approvals before I wrap up. The N60-6 comes in sizes ranging from double extra small to triple extra large, and that biggest size covers a 65 centimeter head. There are two shell sizes to cover that range of helmet sizes. The smaller shell covers helmet sizes up to and including medium, while anything bigger than that goes in the larger of the two shells. In some instances, that will be an issue, especially for people with the smallest and the biggest heads within each of those shell sizes. But instead of padding the lid out with foam to make it fit smaller heads, Nolan have six different thicknesses of EPS impact liner. That means you'll never end up with either crazy thick or crazy thin foam comfort linings, which is always the risk with some helmets that come in only one or two shell sizes. In terms of approvals, as I said earlier, this meets the new and improved ECE 2206 safety standard for the road. So this is currently the cheapest helmet on the market that passes that new test. There are some helmets coming along soon that have a similar price and also meet the new approval. But at the moment, Nolan are the only brand with a sub £400 helmet that meets 2206, and they have two of them, the N88 and this one. So I started this by saying this has to be one of the best value sporty lids around. The fact you can get a lightweight helmet with decent venting, a pinlock insert, a sun visor that doesn't mist up, and a bang up-to-date safety test pass for between 150 and 180 quid is a massive feather in Nolan's cap, in my opinion. After my 300 or so miles in this helmet, I was very impressed. Spending more money on a helmet will always mean you get a more luxurious experience and a few extras that will make life a bit easier for you. But in terms of the important stuff, this helmet does everything that I think a motorcyclist needs, and it shouldn't ruin your bank balance either. I hope that tells you everything you wanted to know about the new Nolan N60-6 helmet. But if there is anything you'd like to ask or to add, then please pop a comment below. Thanks for watching.